Dear students, in the last video we studied the electric field due to the line charge distribution by the Gauss law. That was the first application of Gauss law. In this video we are going to see the second application of Gauss law. Here we are going to find out the electric field due to the plane sheet, and this sheet is uniformly distributed by the charges. See, first of all we are going to draw the diagram. Here it is a uniformly charged sheet, plane sheet, right? The charges are uniformly distributed on the sheet. On the surface of this sheet means we can say that sigma is the surface charge density. Sigma is known as the surface charge density, right? Capital Q is the total charge residing on the sheet. Total charge on sheet, as we know that we studied, that is capital A we can write, or S we can write. S is the area of the sheet. So sigma equal to, therefore sigma equal to total charge per unit area, right? So that is Q equal to, S equal to, we can write, that is 4 pi R square is the area of the sheet, right? That we can say. So this is about the information. First of all we will see what is the electric field due to the sheet, direction of electric field. So electric field is perpendicular to the plane. Suppose we are having the plane, suppose the mobile, we can say that here it is a plane sheet. On that mobile the charges are uniformly distributed over here, right? Uniformly distributed. So electric field, direction of electric field will be towards, due to the positive charge, direction of electric field will be away here, right? In this way. For this side, direction of electric field is like this. So this is the direction of electric field. This is the direction of electric field, right? Now here at point P, see here at a some distance, at some point, suppose here it is the P point we kept. On this P point, what is the electric field that we are going to calculate? What is the electric field over here? So we can take the P point on both sides. Suppose this is the sheet, on this side we can also take P point, and on this side also we can take a P point. These two points are at the same distance from the sheet, either side or side, right? Okay. So suppose we are having this sheet over here. Here it is sheet. The P point is over here. Suppose thumb shows that this point shows the P point. So we are going to choose another points, right? At the same distance. Suppose this is the distance. So another on the upper side, due to this sheet, on the upper side we are taking point. P point is at the center, right? So we can draw another cylindrical shape over here. So this cylindrical shape is known as the Gaussian surface on this side, and this side also there is a one cylindrical surface. So this is the cylindrical surface, P at the center on this side, and this side also we can draw a cylindrical surface, right? We can write it is a P dash point, we can say. Whatever the electric field at point P will be the same at the P dash. So we got a cylindrical surface over here. This cylindrical surface divided into two flat surface and one curved surface, right? So take the points, different points. Suppose here take a P point, suppose A is the point on the flat surface, B is the point on the flat surface, and suppose here C is the point on the curved surface. So we are going to calculate what are the flux linked to the A point, B point and C point, right? So using the Gauss law, the statement of Gauss law, that is flux phi equal to integration over E vector dot ds vector equal to summation of charge divided by epsilon 0, equation number 1. With the help of this equation, what we can write? Flux equal to integration over E vector dot ds vector, equation number 2 we can write. We will simplify this equation number 2, and phi equal to integration over a closed, sorry, we will write the second part of the equation, that is flux equal to this, flux equal to summation of charge divided by this epsilon 0, equation number 3. Now we will simplify, we are going to find out the, or we will simplify the equation 2 and we will simplify the equation 3. Okay, first we will simplify equation 3. So we will write from equation 2. What we can write? See, flux, so flux linked with A surface, flux linked with the B surface, and flux linked with the C surface, right? See, again, here we are going to find out the direction of electric field at point A, at point B, and at point C. What is the direction of electric field at point A due to the sheet? Towards this, this is the direction of electric field. Here it is a flat surface, so area vector will also in the same direction. Same will be over here. Direction of electric field, right, and area, ds vector, right, both are in a same direction. What about C? So about C, direction of electric field will be on this side and area vector will be in the upper side, right. So here the angle is 90 degree, here the angle is 0, and here the angle is 0. For A and B, angle is 0, and for the C, angle is 90 degree. So here, writing this, integration over E vector dot ds vector plus integration flux linking to the B surface, E vector dot ds vector plus flux link with the C surface, E vector dot ds vector. So here E ds cos for the A, angle is 0, cos 0. For the B, E ds cos 0. For the C, E ds cos, for the C surface, C, what is C? For the C, it is 90 degree. So we will write cos 90 degree. 0 degree, 0 degree, and 90 degree. As we know that sine 0, 0, so cos 0 becomes 1. So this term becomes 0, this term and this term becomes 1. So see, answer will be E ds plus E ds plus 0, right? E is constant, so taking outside, E outside, integration of ds plus E outside, integration of ds, E remains as it is, integration of ds becomes suppose s, right? Here integration of ds again becomes s, so it becomes 2 times of es. So flux equal to 2es is the equation number 4. This is the fourth equation. By solving equation number 2, you will get equation number 4. Now we are going to simplify the equation number 3. See, flux equal to summation of charge from 3. What is the equation? That is flux phi equal to summation of charge divided by epsilon 0. Total charges, summation of the charges. Total charge equal to what? Total charge, suppose Q is the total charge, epsilon 0 remains as it is, suppose, right? So if you write like this, so what is the, we will write like this, epsilon 0 Q equal to this, right? So as we know that, as we know that sigma equal to charge per unit area, so therefore Q equal to, we write sigma into S, right? So put the value over here, Q equal to sigma into S. So flux equal to, you can write sigma into S divided by epsilon 0. This is your equation number 5, right? Suppose this is equation number 5. So from 4 and 5, what is fourth equation? Flux equal to 2ES is the fourth equation. And what is fifth equation? Flux equal to sigma into S divided by epsilon 0. This is the fifth equation, right? So from 4 and 5, what we can write? The left hand side and the RHS. RHS is same, so equating this 2ES equal to, right? That is sigma into S epsilon 0. So this S get cancelled. You get the equation E equal to sigma divided by 2 epsilon 0. This is the electric field due to the plane sheet, and the sheet is uniformly charged, right? So this is the electric field. You can write this in a vector form also. E vector equal to sigma divided by 2 epsilon 0 into n cap. N cap is a unit vector in the direction of electric field. This we can write in a vector form, right? So you just take the screenshot of this, right? Okay, no need to write this. Equation number, so this is the question: obtain the electric field due to the charged sheet. This is the second application of Gauss law. Please take the screenshot. Okay, now we will see the third application. See? Third application, it is electric field due to the spherical shell. Third application, electric field due to the spherical shell. This is the last theory of this chapter, right? Okay, our target is same, to find the electric field due to the charges are uniformly distributed along the spherical shell. For that purpose, we will consider first a shell. See, it is a shell, right? This is a shell having radius is capital R. Capital R is the radius of the shell, and on this shell the charges are uniformly distributed. So see, this is the uniformly distribution of charges on the surface of the shell. So that's why again we will define sigma is the surface charge density, total charge Q divided by A. A is the area, or we can write S also, right? So this is the total charge. So we are going to find out electric field at the two points, one is inside, other is outside. First of all, we will consider a point inside. Suppose electric field at a point inside, at inside means suppose here it is a P point at a distance small r. So small r is less than capital R. So point inside the, it is inside the spherical shell. Here we are going to calculate the electric field. What is the formula? Flux equal to summation of charge divided by epsilon 0, also equal to integration over E vector dot we will write S, right? ds vector. This is our mathematical equation of the Gauss law. To apply the Gauss law, we must have to find out the Gaussian surface. For the Gaussian surface, we will choose a point like a P. Means what? The point P is at a distance r, right? At a distance r. So we are going to consider a point at a distance r, at a distance r, at a distance r. So we are going to consider the number of points which are at a distance r. So this dotted surface, this dotted line indicates the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface. And students, we know that here what we can see, that this Gaussian surface does not enclose any charge. And from the important points, we can see that if the Gaussian surface does not enclose any charge, so flux link with the surface equal to 0, right? So therefore, here we will write, here the Gaussian surface does not enclose the charge, right? Therefore, the flux link with the Gaussian surface becomes 0, right? So this is all about the electric field in flux, the point which is inside the spherical shell, right? Now we will discuss when the point is outside. For that purpose, we will see again a spherical shell. The charges are uniformly distributed. Right? The R is the radius of the shell. R is the radius of the shell. See, this is the R, radius of the shell. And now we are going to consider point outside the shell. Suppose here we are going to consider at a distance r a one point, the point P. We will draw a Gaussian surface, means a point like a P, right, which is at a distance r from the center. So this red line shows a Gaussian surface. This red line indicates the Gaussian surface. This is the Gaussian surface, correct? Now, what is the statement? Flux equal to summation of charge divided by epsilon 0, also equal to integration over E vector dot ds vector. Equation number 1. Also, flux equal to summation of charge divided by epsilon 0. Equation number 2 we can write. Also, we can write integration over E vector dot ds vector. Equation 3 we can write. We solved this all the topics, first application, second application and third application by the same steps. Okay, so solving the equation number 2, from equation 2, what we can write from equation 2? See, from equation 2. So flux equal to summation of charge divided by epsilon 0. Here how many charges are enclosed by the total charge? Q is the total charge enclosed by the Gaussian surface. What is the value of Q here? So suppose sigma equal to charge per unit area. So Q equal to, we can write sigma into A. So what is S we can write, sorry, S we will write S, right? Here it is right, S. So Q equal to a sigma into 4 pi capital R square. Capital R is the radius of the, right? So in this way you can put the value, that is sigma into 4 pi R square divided by epsilon 0. This is the flux link, right? Equation number, it is the equation number 4th. It is the 4th equation. Now we are going to solve equation number 3. So this is from 2nd, now from 3. From 3, what is the equation? That is flux equal to integration E vector dot S vector, right? See students, over here, this is the first slide actually. Here, anywhere, suppose this is the area we are going to consider. Suppose area vector pointing outward, this is area vector. And what is the electric field? This is the electric field. So electric field and area vector both are in a same direction. So E dot E ds cos 0. So here flux will be E ds cos 0. And we know that cos 0 becomes 1. So flux equal to E will be constant, integration of ds. Integration of ds, that is E equal to 4 pi r square area. Area of the Gaussian circle. This is the area, this is the R, so we write 4 pi small r square, right? This is the flux. Equation number, we can see that it is the equation number 5th. It is the equation number 5th, right? So from 4 and 5th, from 4th and 5th, equating 4th and 5th. See, what is the 5th equation? E equal to 4 pi small r square. What is the 4th equation? And that 4th equation equal to flux phi equal to sigma 4 pi capital R square divided by epsilon 0. This is the equation 4th, right? Here, equating 4th and 5th. See, this 4 pi get cancelled. So, we are going to calculate the value of E. So, E equal to, you will get E equal to sigma divided by epsilon 0 remains as it is, divided by this r square. So this is your equation of electric field. Also, if we put the value over here, you will get the next equation. This is the electric field due to the spherical shell. If we put the value of sigma as we have calculated, that is suppose E equal to sigma, for the sigma we can write, see what is the sigma over here, sigma equal to, we can write, that is no need actually, you will finish over here, right? No need to calculate, you can see this much only, electric field due to the spherical shell, E equal to sigma into r square epsilon 0 into r square. This is your final equation for the electric field due to the spherical shell. We can simplify this equation in the next video, or at the time of numericals we will solve this, or we will simplify this equation, right? Take the screenshot. I am arranging the board. Sorry. Second, R is greater than R, right? Point outside. This is for the second point, for the outside.